KickinAss Emos, follow the channel. Thank you, and welcome, because he's coming in right now. Let's get him in here. Today we're just doing something really quick. Wait, where's my camera? I'm all over the place here. Hold on. Cat must have knocked my camera again. Nope. Let's try this again. There we go. Oh, great. Right, he'll be right back. Okay, cool. Fantastic. I'll get this thing started anyway. Get my... I've had all sorts of problems today. I couldn't for the life of me. I spent about an hour trying to troubleshoot my audio problems because I couldn't get the system to recognize my mics. The only mic I could get is the mic that is disabled on my webcam, and the one I don't use is the only one I could get working. And I spent an hour trying to reconfigure Windows and everything else, and it just turned out that my Realtek Audio had this one little switch on it that basically ties all your mics into one mic and it disables your rear panel when you have something plugged into your front panel. So I just threw those two little switches over and everything just came back to normal. So that's all it was, is something. Hello, Azaboy, how's it going? So the audio is hopefully fixed. Can you hear me, or is my mouth moving? Yeah, we're good to go. Good stuff, fantastic. Yeah, that's all it took, was switching one little switch on my Realtek Audio settings. So we are going to look at a map from KickinAss Emos, and let's look at his files. I think I already downloaded it, but I'm going to grab it again just in case. Oh, and I should probably invite you in too. Let's just grab the map first. So this is all we're doing today, just a short one. We're helping him prep his map for a matchmaking consideration, because we're probably going to be submitting these today. Not today, sorry. This week is what I meant to say, this week. Need to fix a couple of things. Yeah, it's not letting me find your maps anyhow, so I'm going to just invite you in. Invite the fire team, invite to party. You're in there somewhere, there you go. And I'm not getting anything in Halo. I'm not even a lobby yet. Unable to retrieve data. Please ensure your privacy settings allow you to review content from other players. Where are your privacy settings? I don't believe I have any, but everything else seems to be resetting today, so let's go check our settings. I know where my privacy settings are, but we'll find them. Preferences. There you are. Where are my privacy settings?
It's... Yeah, let me turn my connection.
No, cat, no. No, cat. Sorry. No, the cat's trying to walk across my keyboard.
It's just like where I'm watching the stream as well. I know how the feed is, because I got the same kind of setup that you do.
Yep.
Except I use OBS, and I'm actually using my Xbox capture card to my TV. So.
Oh. I use
it's pretty cool.
I use Tachyon, which is OBS. It's just it's a reskin. It's Beam.pro uses OBS for their software as well. It's called Tachyon, but it's exactly the same thing. It uses your OBS settings. Like, you turn it on the first time, and it's just, the only difference is the logo in the corner. Otherwise, it's exactly the same. Oh, and they don't have recording functionality in it yet. So unfortunately, I have to use my video on demands to send to YouTube rather than a local capture. So the video quality for YouTube is a bit on the choppy side, because it's through my network connection to them.
Yet the rendering is crazy on OBS too. Like, if you don't have a good connection, it's crazy. So it's weird how I had that set up, because it's exactly like yours, except I'm using the Xbox app to stream, but I'm drawing it over to my TV, and I'm actually using my laptop for my Twitch and my layout for OBS.
Oh, okay.
So it's all like, same thing.
It sounds confusing. The difference, yeah. I use an HDMI splitter. So my Xbox goes into my HDMI splitter.
I use it to my TV, to my Xbox, and to my laptop.
Oh, I do the same thing, but I also send one to the capture card. So it's getting the same. It's getting I don't stream through the capture card to the monitor. I just send all four streams and split it to four different places. So similar, but the reason I like using the Elgato. The old one is because I can also stream my Xbox 360 through the same capture card. If I use a new Elgato, which I can't afford anyway, I would have to keep the old one for the 360 and use the new one for the HDMI, which is kind of like what I'd like to do, but one day.
So, you know how we've got double HDMIs in our Xbox Ones, correct?
Yes.
So I actually use a shorter HDMI cable to plug into the second port. And when I stream my 360 games, all I do is switch it over to the TV, and it still pops up on my OBS.
Oh, yeah, you run it through the Xbox One. Yes, I get that. I can't do that because my Xbox 360 is an original, and it only has analog. It doesn't even have an HDMI port. So I have a newer one, but the DVD drive broke on it, and they wouldn't replace it under warranty. So I just have a really good Xbox sitting here, like the Xbox Elite, the black one, and it's just collecting dust because the drive on it doesn't spin, and it's a different drive. So not only that, you can't just swap drives in your Xbox because the
you've got to reconfigure everything. I did that one time, and I was like, I didn't want to send it off to Microsoft, and I was like, I'll just fix it myself, and I did. It took a tedious process.
Oh, it did work? Oh, no, mine wouldn't work because it's a different DVD drive itself, and the DVD drives are tied to the motherboard, like they're signed to the motherboard, so if you put a new one in, it just won't work. Unless it's the exact same one. There are ways to do it. You switch the card as well. Anyhow, it doesn't work.
Give me leader.
First of all, I just want to find out where are the privacy settings, just so I can see if that was the problem. I think it's probably more of their server issues.
Yeah, it's probably where they updated it and were through the preview program, and they're just popping that up just with the active feed.
Third video activity.
You're going to go under your ease of access or personalization. Probably ease of access here. Let me actually go to my settings real fast and just to be on the safe side.
Yeah, I don't see it anywhere in here. Or I'm just missing it.
Okay, privacy settings. If I'm not mistaken, that's like... account, link social, privacy. Okay, you're going to go to your account.
It's under account, right?
Go over to privacy and online safety. It probably propped up because of the whole preview program. Xbox Live privacy. Then go in. Mine's under adult defaults.
Customize your privacy settings.
I would just do it adult, because basically what it's going to do is saying, well, let's go ahead and just, you're good. You're an adult. You don't have to worry about it.
Yeah, but what's custom?
I don't have that on mine. View details and customize. Ah.
Switch and then view your...
Okay, so when it pops up, it's going to basically, like, who can see you online and others can see what you're watching or listening. And I basically have got it set for everyone and then friends.
Okay, here we go. Others can see you online. Everybody, others can see what you're watching or listening to. I have that blocked. Others can communicate. Everybody, others can see your Xbox profile. Yep. Well, that should be everybody. Others can see
your game and app history.
I want everyone to see that. Yeah, game and app, everybody.
Others can see your live TV and on-demand video history.
No, I don't want to see what.
Block that,
I don't want my people to see what porn I download. Music history. I don't use it for music. I use other things for music.
I just did everyone because it's not really. It's like, if you're listening to something, then oh well. Others can see your friends list. I put everyone. Others can see your club.
Everyone can see your exercise info.
Regardless, if you're going to be gold or silver, that's all you. That's all it's going to be able to.
Yeah.
Do.
Shared content.
Everyone on the internet. Game clips and screenshots. I did that. Others can see your exercise info. Everyone. Screw it.
Who can see communicate with you social. Using video? I have it set to friends, but I can send that to everybody. Decide. Oh, add. Allow. Share your real name. Blocked. I only block it because the only place I would
That's
use my real
nice.
Name is on Facebook, and I only use Facebook for people that I can actually touch their face. If I can touch your face, I'll add you on Facebook. So that's how I use my Facebook.
Well, in the same sense of degree that I'm going for, I'm hoping to head up that way.
Yep. Share your real name, block, edit name. Oh, sure. Now I show my real name on stream, so that really helps. I have my name blocked yet. I just show it on stream. I don't really care, as I say. It's just if you come and you want to talk to me, yeah, that's fine, but I just don't want to throw it out there for the general public. So allow. Boy, there's a lot. I thought.
Yeah, that's why it propped it up because of the update, I guarantee it.
You know what? Every time you get this, you can share voice data. Send samples of your voice data to Microsoft to help improve its products and services. So what they're saying is that third parties can listen into what you're talking about, record my voice, and then if I say, oh, that really bugs me, then I'm going to get ads insecticides.
Yep. Oh, Jesus.
Okay, so there we go. That's everything. Let's save that. Oh, you don't have to save it. It saves on its own.
Go to Halo 5.
Okay.
Yeah. And then just go ahead and hit your Xbox button on your controller, and then just go down to Halo 5.
Okay.
It should automatically save no matter when you back out.
Sorry, go to where? Just
hit your little center button on your thing, and then just scroll down to Halo 5. And instead of having to close that out, you can just go ahead and just look
at I'm just gonna reboot the build. It only takes a second.
It should be under my actual files, if I'm not mistaken. We go into my files, click on files. Oh, while they switched it. It's crazy. It should be Molten 2.0.
Yeah, hold on, I'm just loading up here.
So technically, yes, I know you're not supposed to be out of the maps, but...
No, that's allowed. I thought that's completely allowed.
Oh, it's
now.
Allowed?
Absolutely allowed.
Okay.
If you go out of the map...
Because I know you used to not be able to.
Well, the reason why is because the way Forge and multiplayer now are structured... If you're out of the map, you're actually still in the map. You know what I mean? It's not like in previous games. If you were out of the map, you're out of the map. Like, you could get miles and miles and miles outside of outside of Forge World and still Forge out there.
Oh, I know. It's
yeah.
It's
and
crazy.
But now, like, if you found there are certain gaps in the kill volumes you could get through, and you could just forge like under the map and out of the map and stuff. So they won't like stuff like that, even though there was one of the maps in matchmaking was under the water
Empire.
In Forge World. Yeah, one of them was,
was
above or under.
Empire was on top.
Yeah.
Because they had, it was, I think it was a breakout map.
Yeah.
That they had on top of Empire. And then, yeah, because we were doing that.
Yeah, but now it's completely allowed. There's no problem. If you can get out there and get past the kill volumes, but you're kind of at your own risk because if they change the kill volumes at a later date, we could ruin your map. So that's the only.
I hope they don't.
Yeah,
I
hope so too.
Because.
But I always go through all my maps whenever I do it. Whenever I do an update, I always go through my maps to see what's broken and what's changed on them. And almost every update has changed something, including the saddest thing. Of all is my rings don't spin anymore, and I'll bitch about that for the next month until they get spinning again.
Yeah, I definitely, because the last time, like I said, we talked was on Hill of Reach, and I had that, enormous kill ball on each side that actually bounced up and down. I don't know if you remember that or not.
Yeah. But all right, I got your map. So Molten 2.0?
Yep, and then it should be, well, we're going to be in Forge, I'm assuming. If it was going to be game type, it would have been, I can think it was Grifball 2 or something.
Okay, let's go look.
Change teams. It's crazy, like, we used to be able to join in Halo 3 and Halo 4, and before you join, you're able to switch your teams. Now you can't do that.
Yeah. Oh, and I also found out that in Halo PC, you can't switch from red team to blue team. You have to switch to yellow team first and then change to blue team.
That's weird.
It is weird. You change and nothing happens. You just stand there. I have 39 rec packs to open. So once I hit like 46, I'm going to just open them all.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Pretty sure they're all... Oh, update pack. Oh, I never opened that.
Update pack, you'll probably get the hunter gun.
You know, I'm going to open that right now. Yes, Wicked Grass. Berserker's Claw. Nice. I think the rest are all daily logins.
I was hoping for, like, an actual armor piece or something for the update, but they're like, nope.
Company reward. And here we are. Okay, I can't open anymore. We're in Forge.
Company reward.
No, your map is very close to being good. It just needs some containment issues and a few other things taken care of.
I was wondering about that on the top because I remember.
Oh, it's so easy now. You wouldn't believe how easy it is now. You're gonna have to add some invisible blockers.
The first time you had posted that map on Grifball, I broke it within minutes.
Oh, yeah.
Not even minutes, seconds.
Which map?
So, I did see the actual barriers.
You mean the first one that was in matchmaking? Yeah. Mm-hmm. I didn't...
Yeah, the actual...
Here, let's, for the sake of people watching... okay.
Because how I've got it set up in custom games...
This is above Molten. See, there's Molten down there, and we are above it, and this is friggin' phenomenal. Wish you could...
See, I thought, I'm gonna show you, actually, without the grid. I was kind of debating on it, on changing the grid to actually not putting it at all.
Oh yeah, there's no generate lighting on the dev maps, is there? So we can't...
Yeah, well, there is, but I turned it all off.
Oh, I'd rather it be on so we can actually generate lighting and see what it looks like. Is that something you can turn on in the settings now?
My alarm's going off.
Oh, that's not good. Go put the fire out first, then come back. Don't, fire is more important than Forge.
No, it was just my alarm clock.
Okay. One thing I would suggest, first thing I would suggest is the flame drawings that you have on the floor, make them all the same color, like all three primary, secondary, and tertiary, all the same color to get rid of the alternate colors on them. So that's something I would do. That's just my first suggestion. I've got 1,000 more. And yeah,
like I said, I came in here and fixed all that, the alignment and everything.
Oh, so yeah, and there's some pipes missing over here.
Yeah, I'm probably going to remove those. Because what I did was because in order to get it under standards, my map was huge when I first started. I mean, it was massive.
Yeah.
So I shrunk it down, but all I can do is, on this side...
Okay, I also notice your spawns are out of whack, but we can fix that in about 3 seconds.
Okay. I just had them all grouped together, that way I would have it, because when I try to do a custom game and I just had the initial spawns up top, like once you died, you didn't...
Yeah, no, I have prefabs now for all the Grifball Court elements. So what we do is we just grab the ones we need, and you definitely need the spawns. So what we'll do is we'll all I need to know is the measurement of your what's it called here?
Ball spawn.
Yeah. Ball spawn.
Keep going over.
Yeah, it's gonna say that's not in the center, is it? Like it's not visually, it's not in the center of your map.
It's not.
No, it's way off. Either way, you know what? It doesn't matter. Let's just delete your ball spawn, delete your goals, and delete the spawns that are on the floor. And we're going to drop the prefab for that.
Okay, hold on. And you want me to delete the spawns, correct?
Yes, just do a select all and delete them all. Okay. And the ones on this side as well. And don't worry about the starting spawns. They're fine. We're going to fix all those later. Okay.
I had it grouped together. I didn't want the light to go away.
Okay, so look in my prefabs. So you just go to add a prefab. So you just go to your spawn and object prefabs, and you're going to search my prefabs for Grifball 4v4 respawns. Here, I'll just do it on screen so everyone can see in the stream what we're doing, what we're talking about. You go to my...
Is it under the map, or is it actually on their tools?
It's under... No, you go to, like, place an object, the spawn an object.
Okay.
And that very top is prefabs, okay?
Okay.
So you go to prefabs, and then you might have to do a custom search to search for mine. You're going to look for a Grifball 4v4 respawns. Now, if it doesn't
all I did was, since you were in my party, I just went ahead and just saved it to you. So, okay, so...
If it won't allow you to spawn, like, if you don't have enough room to spawn it, it won't allow it to spawn, so you just have to fly out of the top of your map and spawn it up there.
Okay, so is it the Grifball 4v4 respawns?
That's right. And as I say, it probably won't spawn because you don't have enough room in here, so you might have to go fly out of the top and spawn it up there.
Okay, so I did save that.
Oh, you don't have to save it. Just you can you're better off to bookmark it. Everyone does the saving thing, and it's nailing their servers, because every time that if you bookmark it, it only saves once in the server, but if you save it, then everyone who saves it also has a copy of it in theirs. You only have to bookmark it. And I think they need to work on that. They need to make the save option like hidden or somewhere off to the side and make the bookmark prominent, like the very first thing you can do is bookmark it. I noticed that in the UI. There's a lot of things that are wrong about the UI, like change name is the top of the list rather than play in Forge or play in custom game. Those should both be at the top of the list. But that's all stuff they can work out with community feedback. You found it?
Yeah. It wouldn't let me drop it at first.
Yeah, so where's the top of it? I can't see it. That one's a hard one to see.
I've got it outside of the map.
Okay, so see this invisible block right here, the very top piece? Just grab that and slide it into the ceiling of your map. Okay, set your rotation snap to 45 degrees.
Got it already.
And turn it 45 degrees. Oh, wait. I have to figure out which way to turn it, because I wanted you to match... So blue side is over here, and red. So you want red side. Oh, I hit the fire. You want red side to be over here. So is this red? Yes, red side is over there. You go.
I've got it flipped already.
Okay, so put the come down here, and put the capture plate right in the middle, and just so it's just slightly under your invisible blocker. And make it dead center. Actually, that light down there looks like it's centered. Maybe you should magnetize it to that light down there to see what position that is, because that looks like it was measured to the center. Yeah, just turn on magnets and drop it, stick it to that light down there to see what the light, what the center is. Does it stick with magnets? If not, you can change the parent to the, make the parent the capture plate if the magnets don't work.
Not
okay. Did it? Okay, then bring it back up.
No, it's not magnetized.
Oh, then just all you, just change the parent to make the capture plate the parent. Just turn it so that the capture plate's okay. Blue. Change the parent object. That's cool. For me, it disappears on the screen every time you change it.
Yeah.
Is it the parent?
It is now.
Okay, and that now it'll stick with magnets to your light. Okay, and then just use, don't pull it up, use the coordinate system to raise it up. Like, don't do it by hand. Use the object position system, the coordinates, X, Y, Z, and change your Z coordinate to raise it up. There you go. And stop as soon as it peaks out of the top. All right, whoa, down. 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 There you go. Perfect position. Let me just check your spawns. Yeah, your spawns are perfect. Okay. So that's your standard griffball size. So your court is still a little bit on the big side. So you have two choices. You can reconfigure your whole court, or you can just make your court a longer and narrower griffball court, so or just a larger griffball court, or you can just leave everything where it's at. I mean, that's not a big deal. It's just,
I mean, I want, see, the whole point of doing this is I want to make sure I'm doing everything correctly, and if
okay,
anything I can move, I mean, honestly, it's not going to be
A big deal to move everything, because this is Forge. It's just some, your pieces. Oh no, actually you're good, because it doesn't. You see, you've got the. Let's follow the blue line over here. Oh shoot! This is going to be annoying. Those are going to stay there. Those are going to stay there until we leave and come back. So I should not have done
that. Actually, no. Hold on.
Oh yeah, you could just move.
Is that moving now?
No, they're staying. You know what? Let's just talk about it first, and we'll save and then come back. This whole blue thing, you can just group this, like group these elements as they are. Like the whole blue thing, like I'm following the path that I'm walking. Just make this as one group all the way up to here. And then when you move your walls in, just make it match up again from where the corner to corner. So they're going to overlap slightly, but there's nothing wrong with that. You see this line here? You're just going to realign this to the new walls of the court. So you're going to make this all as one group. And then the orange flame down the middle, you don't have to touch it at all. And the red flame over here. So you'll just have to like group them all as individual groups and make them line up to the new one. The ones in the corner, the ones that radiate from the corner, just make them one group. And when we place the new walls, you can just plunk those down so they fit the new wall. So it's going to be very easy. It's just a matter of what you might have to do though is I would just get rid of the invisible floor, and then we'll just add a brand new one afterwards, because it's going to be a pain in the butt forging through these invisible blockers.
Well, I've got it all.
Oh, they're
set
all glass, right? Oh,
yeah,
they're all glass. Okay, just
they're all invisible.
Okay, here's the thing though.
Yeah, so
it's glass, right? The floor is glass, or is it invisible blockers?
Correct.
It's glass, right?
It's glass.
Okay, here's the problem that a lot of forges fall prey to, is they're all grouped, right?
Yes.
When you make large groups, the game tends to shift the position of them, and they're no longer precisely placed.
Yeah, I've noticed that.
So I do not group anything related to floors. I just place the floors and I lock them. I don't group them. I just lock them once they're placed. Because as soon as you make a group of it, you get little cracks and lines showing up all over the place where you didn't have them before. So you're going to have to rebuild this floor from scratch anyway. So I just recommend just delete it until your build is complete. It's just going to be a pain in the butt trying to forge around it. Just remember where it is. Like, before you get rid of it, take a note of the height of it. Oh, okay. Have you gotten rid of it? Is that...
No. It's
oh, because I just noticed that the capture plate is floating now where it wasn't before. Oh, you raised it up. No, I would put it down right to where it's supposed to be and leave it there, and don't touch that again ever. Just leave it there. And then just work around the position of it. So yeah.
I didn't even move the capture plate. I actually moved the actual invisible blockers.
Okay. Oh, that's what you did. Oh, so there's glass, and then on top of the glass was invisible blockers.
Yeah.
Oh, I get it. Yeah, you know, you could probably...
So, smooth, because the whole thing, like, when you were shooting at the actual glass, and it makes that freaking, like, god-awful
freaking, I see.
Like, lag.
I see, yeah.
So...
Okay, so the floor is actually going to be where this is, because if that's the case... The problem with that is the 343 doesn't like it when the players are floating too high in the air. It looks silly. So if you're on glass, the invisible floor should only be 0.1 unit above the actual glass. So it looks like you're still walking on the glass.
See, that's what I wanted, so you can actually see, you know, molten from a different point of view. That's why this map I chose.
Yeah. I think the problem, though, I honestly would get rid of the glass, and the only reason why is the glare is just atrocious on it. You can't really appreciate molten being underneath you because you have this fake reflection. Like, you're seeing reflections of things that aren't here. You know what I mean? Because the reflections actually have an image. I would just get rid of the glass entirely and just make it a grid floor. And then paint the grid the proper color that looks good on this map and get rid of the glass altogether, because the reflection on it is just terrible. Now, the grid has a bit of a reflection too, but I don't think it's quite as bad as a glass. So anyhow, that's my advice. You don't have to do that if you don't want to. You can just leave it, but
okay, so
it's just that you get such a...
I just deleted the glass.
I still see it. Oh, you deleted some of them.
No. Wait, did I? Huh.
Yeah, because I'm still running into some pieces of glass. I can still see them, yeah. Yeah, here's one here.
Okay, so that's what I did. I had them angled. Crap.
How many grids do you have? You have... Oh, they're 200 by 200?
Two.
What? Why do they look... Oh, they look small because your cord is big. That's why. Okay.
Yeah. That's why.
Okay, well, there's something else because I'm seeing these green lines of things that I've selected or whatever. What? See, I thought you could use two 200 by 200 grids.
Okay, so...
Oh, you must have had a bunch of them, like, overlap. Okay, so right now you have no floor whatsoever. Okay, cool. Okay.
Yep, correct.
Now, what I would do is just put a grid down so that you can drop into human mode, but don't place it. Just slap one down underneath so that if you drop it into human mode, you don't die. Or you don't accidentally drop anything off the map if you're placing it. And then I go around and start grouping the... Oh, it looks like you do have them grouped. Mm-hmm. Oh, you do have all your flames and things grouped, so they're ready to go. Oh, very nice. So, yeah, it looks like everything is properly grouped the way I suggested. Yes, it is.
I can't find the freaking grid. It's
oh, the grid are under oh, that's a weird you can see a void underneath the map down there. That's kind of that's kind of weird.
Yeah.
But you can't see it from everywhere. DJ Blue is messaging me. What's he have to say?
Oh, there it is. It's under freaking props. Most weirdest spot to have.
Yes, right. Oh, sorry, you were still looking for that. I was going to tell you where they were. Yeah, so just place four of them that join in the middle. And put it underneath everything. Don't put it above. Put it underneath everything you're working on. Just as I say, just something to catch it. So yeah, just put four of them that all meet in the middle. Because I just don't like falling to my death when every time I go to human mode. But yeah, perfect. Just down that nice and low down
and
there.
They're magnetized, correct?
If you have magnets turned on, yes. Yeah, just make them join in the middle. Like, they should all meet in the middle.
Just meet in the middle? Well, it's not. There's no middle. Oh, there it goes. So, like, each corner meet in the middle, or what?
Yeah, just so that it fills the whole area. Yeah, they don't have to be positioned perfectly. Just so that they fill the whole space. That's all. Hold on a sec. Wait. Why is it showing? It's showing that there are blockers under your map. I can't see them.
Yeah, I had that for the... Huh? Can't see them.
No, it's weird. I can't see them. I'm standing on them, but they don't... Blockers don't always show for all players in a Forge match.
That's weird.
But they're grouped, right? So you're going to have to rebuild them anyway.
Yeah, they're grouped.
Yeah, I would just delete them. Oh, I can see one of them now. Yeah, you're gonna have to delete those and put new ones in anyway. So you might as well just delete them because those are other things. Like the ones on the wall, it's okay to group, but for the floor, you can't group them, or it'll be a bumpy disaster eventually. And the funny thing is, the bumps don't always show up right away. They could show up like 3 weeks from now. You load your map, and all of a sudden your floor is all bumpy. So make these grids underneath everything else, so we can still forge everything else above it. Going the wrong way.
I know. It's being silly.
If you change your movement type to world, it should move it smoothly, like on a 90-degree angle.
It wasn't duplicating.
Like, oh, because you didn't have the room to duplicate it. Yeah, it's cool. The Forge on the PC, it'll duplicate it no matter what. It'll just find a position for it. But you can other than prefabs.
This,
yeah, and just grab the whole thing and drop it down underneath. There you go. Perfect. Perfect. As I say, just something to catch us if we fall or if we accidentally drop something. Okay, so you have all your pieces are all grouped together. Okay, these platforms back here where the lights are, group them together and group the light with them as well, so the light moves too. So use the light as the actual parent piece and group the whole platform around it. Now, this is going to go under the goal. Is that correct?
Yes.
So, yeah, you can move that to the goal right now. I just realized my chat wasn't updating. Sorry, anyone who might be chatting. It was still stuck on yesterday's for some reason. Oh, there we go. It's working now. As the boy said, the best Grifball map he's seen is the Chinese one, and if we're going to be looking at that later today. Because it was he rebuilt it, he rescaled it from legendary size to standard size. So we're going to look at that today afterwards. Okay, so that's all grouped, and the light is grouped as well. And now you can, as I said, you can slide it to this and magnetize it to your to the capture plate if the magnets stick. And then just stick it to the magnet, leave it alone, go do the other one. What I'll do is I'll change the capture plate to the parent object, okay? Just take it. A second. Okay, there we go. So actually stick the light, the magnet on the light to the capture plate.
Oh, there it goes.
Where'd the capture plate go?
Set.
Oh, there it is. Okay.
There it goes.
Now you don't bother dropping it down to position. We'll do that after. So let's go do the other one. I'll change the capture plate to the parent so that it'll activate its magnets. There we go. Is that correct? Is that blue? Kind of hard to see, but yeah, that's blue.
Uh-oh.
I love the way on this screen everything falls apart and breaks and then snaps back together. Okay, there you go.
There we go.
So that's fine right there. What we'll do is once we set the floor, then we'll just drop these to be one pixel under the floor. So we'll just do that later. So that's fine. They're fine right now. Right, we're not sure about the floor height. So what I would do is this middle one.
If I need to, like I said, I can reposition everything.
Yeah, I was gonna say everything's grouped anyhow, right? So that's not a problem. What let me just change I'm going to change this to the parent now, because this is kind of important piece to have centered in the map.
Correct.
Unfortunately, I can't see the color on it because of the oh, there we go. I can see it now.
Okay, so are you wanting it actually to the light, or do you want the light to go to
the capture plate, but I'm going to... We're going to use the capture plate as the new center of the map. So what we're going to do is I just want to see what the position is on it. The position is, it's very close. Let's make it an even 650 by 82. So 650 by 82 is now the center of the map. So it's a nice even number. Now you can just group this and the wiggly lines that are attached to it all together. And do the same thing, just magnetize it to the capture plate, and then we'll drop it down later as well. And after we do that, then we'll do the same thing with all the other lines. So yeah, just magnetize it to the capture plate, and that'll make it dead center as well, by default. Or you can just use the measurements I gave you. 650 by 82. Oh, that's if the... you can use the rings, or you can use the light as your center, because the rings will have the same thing as their center.
Now, should I bring the light up?
Because we're going to be adjusting the height on everything to the... What we're going to do is we're going to match the height of your floor to just under one pixel under the spawns, or one unit under the spawns. And then we're going to move all of your items to one or two units below that, so that they're nice and smooth, but still close to the player's feet.
You said it was 650, right?
650. Well, that's if the parent is the light. Is the parent the light?
No, it's not.
Okay, if you make the... Since the parent doesn't seem to be attached to this piece, If you make one of these rings the parent, it'll be the same measurement, because the center measurement on a ring I'm forgetting my high school geometry. What's the center point on a ring again? It's the axis, or is it the circumference? That's like around. Diameter is across. What's the bloody center point of a ring called? Because it's always the same. Is that looks like that looks correct?
I just kind of did it by looking it up.
Oh, okay, that works too. You have a good eye, because it looks correct. Actually, it looks a little bit off. If you
the only thing like this right here that
I know how to fix it. If you're doing it by eye, here I got something that'll help you. If you're doing it by eye. If you're doing it by eye, just do this. There you go. Use that if you're doing it by eye. I just put some cables down and magnetize them to the gold plate. Oh, you know what? I should drop them down a bit too. There you go. So just line everything up with those, then delete it when you're done. There's my trick. Your trick of the day, we just made some crosshairs on our map so that you can visually line crap up with it and have it perfect without having to measure anything.
I think that looks about right.
Actually, come down over here. You'll see it's off by one unit right here. If you look at the end of this... On the end here, you see the pipe cap sticking out there. And it's not sticking out on this side, so it'd have to be sticking out evenly on four sides. Or not sticking out at all, one or the other. Yeah, it's sticking out on two sides, but not the other two sides. Oh, and sorry, it's a 64-foot ring, and it's a 64-foot pipe. Or cable, or 96, I should say. So the end of the pipe should absolutely match the edges of your circles.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, what happened?
I don't know. It all freaked out.
Yeah, so just go corner to corner, side to side. You see right here, you see how this wire is sticking out here? You should only be able to see the end of it sticking out. Just the very edge of it.
Oh, Jesus.
Do you still have magnets turned on? Turn your magnets off.
No, it's where it's mixed. It does that.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, and I think you grabbed the middle platform as well, because it's part of the group now. Oh, okay, you also have one problem with your ring. One of the rings is upside down.
Is it really?
Yeah, one of the rings is upside down. You're going to have to ungroup it. I think it's just the one. Oh, wait, is it a half? It's a half. Yeah, one half is upside down to the other. And you can see that right here, if you look on the screen. You see how one's rounded and one's square, and one's square and one's rounded. So one of them is up, one of them needs to be flipped. So what I would do is flip them, magnetize them, and then group them. And then do the 165 by 80, or the 6, whatever, 65 by 82, whatever the center is. And just stick with magnets just so that they're exactly the same. Okay, you've got a little bit of variant going on. Can I fix, let go of your rings. I'm going to fix them for you. One of your rings,
I don't have them at all.
One of your rings has lost its precision, and I'll show you how to fix that. Okay. So what you do is you turn your snap on to 45 degrees. You go into your object properties and you go to rotation. And then you just turn each one of those numbers forward and back, and that resets it back to its orientation. It's actually more accurate than doing reset orientation. So rotation, so you just turn each one of them once, and it perfectly sets them again. And now if you look at the rings, they are perfectly aligned with each other, like they're bang on. So they're together. So here, let's group them. Oh, you've got another set of rings in the middle of it.
Really?
Yeah, the decorative one. Oh, that's great. There's nothing wrong with that. That looks good. I just want to make sure that I'm going to grab each one individually, and I'm going to set them all to the same position. There you go. That's how you line them up. Oh wait, they should be. They should be the same. Oh, wait a sec. Oh, I will do them separately. I just realized I had the Z coordinate wrong. They don't line up to the other ones. You want them to be higher than the ones in the stick out of the side, right? Yeah, definitely do.
Yeah.
In that case, I'm going to have to grab these rings and raise them up. I'll raise them up and I'll put them back down in a second. So we'll grab these two and we'll drop them. And now we'll drop these ones back down so they still stick through. Is that about the right height right there? Do you want it higher or lower?
Oh, that's fine right there.
That's fine right there? Okay. So we will take these four and group them because they're all perfectly positioned. So they are now grouped. Okay. And I'm going to reconnect your S's here because they've kind of lost their precision as well. So all I'm going to do is remagnetize everything. And that just makes them line up a little bit better with each other. So let's group this. 1, 2, 3. We're probably only going to need 3, but We'll keep them together just... wait a sec, sorry. The Z coordinate is absolutely correct on them, so very good. So group those rings, and then we're going to attach it to this ring, and I'm going to do the four on the other side. Oh, one of them's upside down, so I'll fix that. This one's upside down. And this one's upside down. Okay, so select all four and make sure they all have the same Z coordinate. And they do, so that means I can group them. And, wait a second. I have to move them in slightly because they lost their positions, sort of. There we go. Okay, so your wiggly lines and your center ring are perfect. How's this piece doing? Looking good?
I think I just fixed it. Yep, I did. Yeah, individually ungroup them, and then actually line it up with the capture point.
Yeah, they've still all lost their position. So I'm just gonna I'll show you that. I'll do that same trick again on this. Is I'm gonna ungroup them.
Okay, so when you grab it.
Wait a second.
And then when you do that, you said going into rotation, correct?
Okay. Well, wait. You have to have all four of them at the same time. So grab all four pieces at the same time individually. Okay. So.
Ungroup.
Don't group them. Just ungroup them. Just have all four pieces selected. Okay, and then just go into rotation, and then manually just change. You'll see that it'll say mixed, and then set it back, and then and then hit the next one, set it back, and then hit the next one and set it back, and they should all end up back in the same position. Okay, you did it wrong. You grouped them and.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, you did something wrong with it. It's okay. Actually, you can still fix it. You just have to turn the rotation. Keep going. Two of them are right. Actually, make it so one of them is right. Just make it so one of them is right, and then turn each one manually.
Okay.
Oh, sorry, my bad. I gave you bad instructions. You were supposed to do them individually. Either way, they're fine now. So just turn them all back.
It's all right. They should be good now.
Yeah. What you do then is once you have them. Once they're all in the right position, this time select them each one and make sure their Z coordinate is exactly the same for all four of them. Make sure your Z coordinate isn't mixed.
Let's say on position or under rotation?
Under position, your Z coordinate should say, it'll say mixed. Make sure that it's the same number.
Okay.
So this is a good time to raise them up if you think they're too low. So I would raise it up
okay,
a little bit.
Okay, it says Z is 333.72.
Okay, perfect. So move it up until it's a bit higher. You see how it's higher than the outer ring? You want it to be kind of the same? Yeah, there you go. Right there is good. Right there is good. Not too high. Take it down one. Take it down one. Perfect. Okay.
334.35. Okay.
Okay, now what you're going to do is you're going to grab one of them. And then you're going to magnetize the next one to it, then what you're going to do is just go around in a circle, make sure they're all stuck together nicely with magnets, because there's a little bit of a gap on one of them. See, because now that after you did the rotation thing, they're all perfectly reset, and they should stick together with magnets.
There's still a gap right there.
Okay, there's still a gap?
I got it.
Oh, you got it. Okay. Yeah, just making sure that there is no gaps anywhere. Okay, you're looking good. Beautiful. Okay, so...
I knew Forge from the get-go from Halo 3 was tedious, but, I mean,
yeah.
There's so many specs you gotta go by. It's
I know. Crazy. So what I would do now is group these four pieces together.
Okay.
And then group it with the ring that's on the outside of it. Now your whole centerpiece is all one big piece. Now, you're probably never going to have to touch it, but you want it to be all grouped together in case you have to raise it up and down. And I will get
okay,
rid of
so
the...
You grouped everything, the little small rings
together, the
right?
Rings and the wiggly lines on the outside, yes, I grouped those all together as one. So just make it one big group of that other thing in the middle.
All right, should I lock that, just to be on the safe side? So
I wouldn't worry about it. Well, yeah, you can. So just don't ungroup it. That's the main thing, because we're going to be raising it and lowering it later, okay? So as it is, these plates are okay except for the height. All your other rings are perfectly positioned for moving shortly, so we can start moving stuff. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab the template that has my... it just says rings and... here, I'll just show you what it says. Prefabs. It's under my prefabs, and it's called Grifball Cam Rings and Walls. Now, you're only going to be using that for measurement purposes, because you're going to delete it as soon as you're done with it. So don't ungroup it. Just fly out, spawn it, and put it in the map. Let me know when you find it.
Said it was the Grifball Cam Rings and Walls.
Cam Rings and Walls, yes. Let me know when you spawn it. Okay, up there. Now, here's the trick.
That's down below.
Yeah, okay. You see the very top of it? Okay, let it go for just a sec. Let it go. You see the very top of it? There is an invisible blocker. just magnetize that invisible blocker to the one that's already here, and then it will be perfectly aligned with your spawns. So just stick it with magnets and block it up. There you go. It's in perfect position now. See, now what this indicates is where you're going to be putting your walls. Oh, wait, sorry. Turn it 45 degrees again, right?
Oh, crap.
Yeah, just grab the wall. Just select the wall down here. And then so that you don't have to accidentally grab the wrong block. So just grab the wall and just look forward and do a 90 or 45 and then 45 or 90 degree, whichever you want to do. Grab the wall that you just placed. No, don't move it. Just rotate it. Just rotate it 45 or 90 or whatever. Just turn it 90 degrees.
90 degrees?
Yeah, you have to rotate it. Spin it around. Yeah, there you go. You're good. Okay, and make sure it's stuck back with the other cube. Okay, they're stuck together. There you go. You see what this indicates now? This is the height that your ring should be. You see these rings? So we're gonna match your rings with these rings. Now you may have to lower them one or two units because of there's some height variation on this one, but they'll give you a good idea of what to go by. And it also shows you where your walls are going to end up. Now you're making your court square, right? You're not using the angled walls, is that correct?
I can do the angled walls.
You can do the angled, then just match these perfectly. Now, the way these work is you put your wall behind this wall because this is where your clamber ledge should be. So you see how you've got a clamber ledge? This ledge here? You see this ledge I'm walking on?
Yep.
So you move that, and it's really nice because there's 128 foot pieces of those, which is exactly the same as what these are. So you're just going to take one of those and just magnetize it to the wall I have here. And then when you do the angled pieces on the side, you just do another one and just turn it 6 degrees. And you're just going to stick it with magnets to this. And the backs of these are what you line your back wall up with. So these are perfectly set up for clambering. If I can get there from here, hold on. Yeah, these walls are perfectly set up for the right height for clambering and for griffball. So the invisible blockers you've got, you can reuse those, but just you can do those afterwards. Actually, you only need three of those now. Oh, wait, you don't need the ones in the bottom anymore. The invisible blockers here, you just don't need those. The bottom set. Oh, before you do any of that, you're going to end up burying some pieces. So, you know your designs on the floor?
Yeah.
You're going to pull them in to the back into the court and put them back into position and relay out all your lines or your fire lines.
It's going to probably have to. I'll probably have to individually, like, tweak it.
Yeah, well, here, if I grab this one here, you see, you just pull it in. You just pull it in until it's where you want it. And there it is. And then that one, you just pull it over and pull it in. It's got to go in towards the middle as well.
Yeah, see, that's what I'm saying. I may have to shorten it up, too.
Yeah, yeah. Once you figure out where it's going, you might have to just remove a few pieces of it that are on the end. Unless if you want them to overlap with the red ones coming from the other side, that might look cool, too. So I wouldn't go deleting anything yet. I would see what they look like first, because look at this. This fire piece here almost exactly matches my ring. This piece here, look at that. And if you put the other one on, maybe you can match the other side of the ring. Look at that. Oh, wow. You accidentally made it perfect. Look how it perfectly Z fights with the ring I put down. So, Grifball players are used to this ring being here, and you've just repurposed it to fit your needs. So that is really cool. Oh, and while you grab them, each time you grab one, change the colors as well, so that the colors are all blue on the blue ones, And they're all red on the red ones?
Yeah, and they're all red on the red.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a lot of stuff going on. Let me actually...
So, and as I said, you see how you have the height matched up to my rings? You're going to have to lower it by one or two units. So it's just slightly, just click on the, just knock it down two on the Z fighting, or on the Z coordinate. Only because you want a little bit more room on top, because you've got like this ring on top of the ring here, and this ring here is higher than this one. So... Okay. Wait, it should match. Wait, I'm gonna raise the one on the middle one just to see where it should be, and then try to match them.
I kind of hate to break up our live chat and all that. I'm gonna get ready for work.
Actually, I have to go as well. I have commitment in about 10 minutes. So what I'm going to do is position. I'm just going to raise this ring up so that you know where to position yours. Just have your rings. Hey, you see the gold ring here? This one right here. Have all your rings match the height of this one here. Okay?
Okay.
So ignore all right, my...
So
ignore
the gold
my...
ring that you're working with, so... This one right here.
Yeah, that gold one right there, that's the target you're shooting for right there, okay? So you're going to make all your rings that height. You're going to bring in all of your walls so that they perfectly match the walls I have here. And then you're going to bring in your back walls to line up with the backs of these pieces here. And did you want to pick this up again tomorrow? Actually, I have an appointment at this time, or around 2, I think, tomorrow. Let me just check.
Just like I said, just message me, let me know, and if I have to, I'll wake up early.
Yeah.
I usually get up about 2 a.m. So just give me a heads up. I'll probably, once I get done with work, I'll probably be working on this.
Okay. So. I doubt I'll still be up at that point.
Well, I mean, I figured that.
Yeah. So what time is best for you?
I'm a night owl, so.
What time is best for you?
I guess you said your appointment's like, what, 4 or 2?
No, any time. Actually, my appointment's at 11:30 in the morning, so we're good.
Okay. All right. Yeah, that'd be fine. We could do 2:00 again. That way, I'd have enough time to get ready for work and stuff as well. Because I work Monday through Friday.
Sure. Yeah. Just send me a message. We'll pick this up tomorrow, and we'll see. You can work on it until then. I'll see how far you've come along, and once we get the court done, then we'll work on the containment and your starting launches. But I think I've given you enough homework for now.
Oh yeah.
Yes. And the other thing to consider is, you see this wall right here? This back wall, that's perfect. You see how far this is sticking out from the wall? That's perfect. So you don't want to be able to clamber on the outside ledges. You only want to be able to clamber on the side ledges.
Okay.
Okay?
All right. Sounds good.
Yeah, so that gives
you plenty.
Appreciate
it. Not
yeah, hard. No problem. This is going to look terrific once it's done. So save it up before
I
go.
All right.
And and don't ungroup these walls that I place, because you're just going to want to be able to delete the whole thing all at once. You just use them for measurements, and then you delete them. Alrighty. Well,
I'm gonna go ahead and head off here.
Okay. So thanks
all
for
right,
helping.
Thank you.
Thanks for this, and thanks for being on the stream, and thanks for everyone for watching. And this will
no
be up
problem.
On YouTube
tomorrow.
Probably tomorrow. So we'll put it up then. Oh, and right. That British lad followed the channel. Thank you very much for following. I hope you enjoyed. All right, I'm out of here. Good night, everyone. Right. Or good morning, or whatever damn time it is. It's good night. Good night to all my UK
all
friends.
Right.
Yep.